Don't ever forget it again.
Never.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Just kidding, we were laughing because we've already been working for about an hour or so, but now we're headed to Starbucks. Good morning, hope you're doing well. Happy Monday to you, fantastic day. And it is another super not September day because it is supposed to be 90 degrees again today. So it's Monday, and Monday usually starts consistently with just making sure that I catch up on a few email things. So that's what I'm doing now. And just getting a little bit of editing, and then we gotta make sure we get a quick boost in because we're running out of days and we haven't done it in a while. So let's get to work. Beautiful day, and we only have so many of these days left, so we gotta take advantage of it today. We're gonna head downtown to Starbucks again.
Road of the world right here. This road is so beautiful. It's like a picture.
This is where I was riding the one day, and they were like, dude, you vlogging?
Seriously?
Yeah, when I was going down this hill. So Pablo has had a few crashes on the boosted board. One of them broke his collarbone. One of them broke his like ankle, basically, so. He's a little bit more hesitant these days to actually, I think, really cruise. So.
This is my favorite part, this whole neck hole stretch.
Under 10 minutes. Right. Slows you down.
But I just don't wanna, if I break something again, man, that would be so, like, mad.
Jenny would sell it on
you. She'd literally kill me, yeah. So I was like, I can still go fast like on certain spurts, like, you know what I mean? But
yeah, just a lot of people asking for like sponsored from Starbucks. The answer is I wish, but no. This one's only about 4 miles or so from my house, but I used to boost here quite a bit because it's just such a fun ride in. So that's what we were doing. Pablo's never boosted here with me, so we want to take advantage of it. We only have a few nice days left until the winter. Or the fall. The fall's beautiful. It just doesn't last long in the Northeast. It basically goes from summer to winter pretty quickly. Let's work. Productive afternoon at Starbucks. It's just before 4 o'clock. It's time to take a nice cruise home. We're just about 5 miles-ish or something around that from our house. Just a great boosting cruise. Can be a little iffy, so safety first.
We pushed real hard.
Growing up, I never rode a skateboard, so it was never like a way that I got around at all. I thought it was like super inconvenient because you had to push and it just wasn't efficient. But then you put a motor on it, a whole different story. And in general, it's always more fun to ride with another boosted board person, but the problem is Pablo had those two falls and now he's like permanently scarred. He rides really, really slow.
And then he was like, yo, what's your YouTube channel? Seriously, he's like crawling. Might as well walk at that speed.
Collaboration, no question, Premier wins because Final Cut doesn't even offer anything. Color, no doubt, Lumetri right. In Premiere. Or I was completely fine with DaVinci's, obviously, but I'm not really even considering that. I don't think DaVinci necessarily is gonna be an option. Audio, no doubt. Final Cut works. I can make Final Cut work. It's not necessarily my preferred method. Rendering, no question, Final Cut does faster. Exporting, no question, Final Cut does faster. And my overall conclusion was like, use Premiere if you collaborate with others and you love full customization without any limits. Use Final Cut if you want a no-brainer, no thinking. Apple makes a decision. Not much customization, but it works. Use DaVinci if you already use DaVinci Color or you want a free editor, because they have a free version.
I think if you're going for speed, Final Cut's the way to go. It's faster, it works well, there's never an issue.
And that's the thing, I think ultimately what we have to decide is do we swallow some speed, which, like we said, we have to also keep in mind the fact that, like, speed isn't the ultimate decision maker. If you bypass the importing and exporting speed, are you actually faster editing in Final Cut or Premiere once you're past the import process? Like
Premiere.
And that's kind of what my thought is too. Because the fact that I like something, I throw it somewhere. I bring it back. I bring it like, and I'm not trying to like detach from storyline or do this. And like every single time I put a fade in on a clip, it automatically puts it into its own storyline in Final Cut. And then if I want to move that clip, now I got to remove from storyline, move it, recreate the thing with how the settings I want. Like, so if you take away the slowness of import and export, but you gain back some fastness in not only time, but do you edit better with no limits in Premiere versus the ease of Final Cut, but some of the annoyances with it.
Plus.
Not necessarily, what's the better program? It's like, what is the best program for the way that we want to work? I think a lot of it comes down to, do we want to edit multiple projects at the same time? The ultimate way that I look at things is that, like, once we start to become efficient enough and have a whole system down, in a dream world, the ultimate goal, we only are ever working on one project. Like, we don't have a 10-project backlog. So when we get all caught up in everything,
to that point.
Well, yeah, and once you get to that point,
yeah.
Then what the heck's the other person do?
Nothing.
They have nothing to do.
Business, I guess, but that's
yeah, which is like isn't a bad thing, but like, yeah. Or more importantly, we bring another editor on, and now they're taking on 1/3 of the editing role. Well, the only way that's possible is with Premiere. If we only wanted Matt to cut an 8:14, well, we can do it with one click of a share. In a team project and that shared folder, or we have to do it with sending drives, copying footage onto it, getting them all the way back. Mm-hmm. You're at 4 days minimum. 4 days minimum of extra time.
As you can see, we're not quite at the decision-making process, but that's for another day. Today is basically over.
See ya. That decision is coming our way soon.
Tea time 7:30.
Dude.
Well, that wraps up another good overall day, another productive day, but I'm constantly torn with just these vlogs and what I want to do with them. I want to upload a video every single day, but I want to make them valuable. And I know there's certain days that are obviously are more valuable than others. Certain days like today that are just kind of, they're Mondays. They're doing some housekeeping stuff. They're doing a little bit of editing. They're doing a little bit of everyday things, but they can be kind of boring, and I know that. So I'm really deciding what I want to do with these daily vlogs and, more importantly, daily uploads. I really think that I want to do some more tutorial videos. I feel like you guys get a lot of value out of those. You've said that you like those a lot. So kind of toying around some different ideas here. I appreciate each one of you that's here. But as I continue to grow this channel and as I continue to see more and more questions come in, it's obvious to me that there's obviously a lot of people that want to learn a lot of different things. And so the more and more that I can provide value in the learning side of things, the better I think this channel will become. So I'm constantly just toying around with different ideas, but I really appreciate each one of you that watches this, and we're all in this together. Would love to hear your feedback. What kind of stuff do you like? Do you enjoy the daily vlogs of just simply seeing what happens in the day in the life of somebody in this business? I just love to know, so I appreciate it. Say hello, tell me where you're from, tell me where you're watching, when you're watching. I love all that kind of stuff. Appreciate each one of you. I will see you tomorrow.